Hello there, it's the archivist from tradingcardarchives.com. Got my blue gloves on and a lot of trading cards on the table here. What we're going to do in this video is something very weird. I'm calling it the Cryptid Conundrum. It's going to be a four set pack war, two packs from each of these sets. And what these sets have in common is they feature cryptids, which is sort of a term that means like half human, half mythical monster kind of thing, right? So it's like a whole subgenre of of animation and everything. And I've got kind of four sets here about that. But before we go through those, let's look at our top cards for the day. We're going to switch one out. So our current top card is this Thanos, which I just love. It's just a gorgeous SGR from Hero Battle. And then this JoJo's Bizarre Adventure from Hot Blood Universe. That's a bootleg anime multiverse set. Both of these are great cards. I'm actually having a lot of trouble figuring out what to switch it out. But I've also got this amazing MR from Tokyo Ghoul. That's a Big Face Studios set. And it is, I mean, just like the JoJo, just has great design work. So I really like it, but I also really like Thanos. So I think what we're going to do is keep Thanos in first place and put the MR in second. And then JoJo, you're getting retired. Sorry. So JoJo's going to the scam pile for later. And I don't have to open any other packs. I have a lot of Star Wars Chrome left, but I don't plan to open any more of it on camera. Not today anyway. So what we're going to do is we're going to get two packs from each of these boxes out and then run the war. So let's first start here with this very shiny thing. If you've watched the channel, you know what this is because I've used it in a battle. I've actually used it in a cryptid battle before, but didn't have this set. So this is the new one. But this is called Abnormity Hunter League. And it's by Camon. So this is the same company that brought us all the SCP trading cards. And this set is interesting because it's kind of their attempt to go legit. So in this set, they are crediting the artists and presumably paid the artists. Whereas in the SCP sets, they just kind of stole everything and made a set of trading cards. So it's good to see that. And I like that. So we like this set. But it really is a Asian version of Metazoo. You'll see when we start opening it, but the cards look very similar. They have the same kind of monsters on them. Like there was a Jersey Devil in this. There's a Jersey Devil in here. There's a Mothman in here. There's a Mothman in here. But they aren't copying each other. In fact, I would be shocked if they even know, you know, other than my channel, that they both exist, right? I doubt Tops knows that exists, and I doubt Camon knows that exists. So they're definitely not copying each other. Also, the Camon set came out much earlier than this set. So if anything, Tops copied Camon, but I really don't think that they did. I think it's just coincidental that they happen to look the same. So this is a hobby box of Metazoo Chrome Series 0. So this was the first Chrome Metazoo release. And these are interesting because they're purely trading cards. They aren't TCG cards, the way some Metazoo cards are. I'm trying to figure out which one to open. I can't tell. But you can see there's a lot of curve to these packs. So the cards that come out of here, they're chrome, but they are curved chrome, which happens often with that chrome stuff. So maybe we'll use those two packs. And we'll save the rest of those for another day. So there's Metazoo. And you can see there, Cryptid Nation. Like, this is not a word I made up. This term is used all over the place. In fact, there's a very fun movie. I won't say it's a funny movie, but it's a fun movie called Cryptozoo. If you ever find that movie, give it a watch. I know it won't be easy, but if you stick with it, you'll like it. Okay, and so this next set is, again, cryptid in the sense that it's anthropomorphic ladies with, you know, like this is a cat lady. But this is called Beast Mother, and there's all sorts of different animal lady combinations in this set. It's technically a waifu product, Although it is, so it's, over 18, it's meant for adults only, but it really doesn't have very much not safe for work artwork, at least not that I've opened so far. So I've been comfortable showing every card I've pulled so far on camera. I don't have very many packs left. You don't get a lot of packs with this particular product, Beast Mother. But I think it's a great one to get. Like, I've enjoyed opening it. I kind of really like the cards that are in there, and yeah, I've never really been disappointed. So we'll use those two packs as well. And we'll put the rest away for another day. Then finally, this is sort of the reason we did this video. This whole video is just an excuse for me to open more of this. So this is another Cryptid waifu set, but this one is from Japan. So this is, maybe printed in China, but the cards are all in Japanese. There you can kind of see there, like that's, katakana right there. So this is definitely Japanese cards. You can see the rarity system here. You've got common, rare, SR. The highest card I've pulled so far is an SR, and I'm really eager to see what a SSR or a UR look like, because the SR looked amazing. And when I first opened this, the box had these two wings in it, but they came off very quickly, and they're kind of advertisements for other Monster Girl Encyclopedia products. So like this is an advertisement for one of the books. That's kind of what that is. So what we'll do here is the same as before. We'll just kind of grab two packs, and I'm feeling good about those two. And we'll use them for the battle. And so the theme again is cryptids. Just we're mixing now. It just so happened that in the cryptid world, you often intersect with waifu stuff. It just happens. And so two of them are that. The two aren't. Like this is has no waifus in it at all, I think. I hope not. And neither does this. So we'll see a little bit of everything here by opening these. I want to save that one for last. So we'll do it in this order. And we are gonna do an actual battle. It'll be informal, but I am gonna try and pick winners. So I'm gonna bring up my positions. This is in Chinese, but it says first place, second place, third place. Probably figure that out. And without any more talking, let's get into it. We only have eight packs to open, so we should be able to do this in about 20 minutes. At least that is my goal. Here we go. Our first pack of Abnormity Hunter League is what this is called. And it's the 5 UM box, although I have never seen it sold in any other configuration. I've only ever seen this sold in this 5 UM version. And the cards are they are kind of chrome, you'll see on the front. Here we go. So this first one is the Wisdom Flame. Wisdom Flame is sort of the mythical thing being represented by that card. Next up we have so that's funny. It's Mars. So Mars is the god of war. But if you watch CryptoZoo, there's a character in CryptoZoo that looks like that too, and it's really funny. I was hoping it was that, but no, that's Mars. And then next up, I kind of want to flip these because I'm pretty sure those are like major hits down there. I didn't intend to pull them, but I think I pulled a pretty big hit. So this is the North Devil. And if you look these up, they all are mythical creatures from all over the world. This is the poor god. And they're just being depicted on these cards. And so it's very similar to Metazoo in its subject matter and also its presentation, which I think is super interesting. Okay, so next up we have a kind of dog. Who is that? That's the Hellgate Keeper. Okay, so it's Cujo. Or I don't know, whatever you want to call that. There's the dog. And then, man, there's a lot of cards in these. 4, 5, 7, I guess we're going to get. Wow, that's a nice looking SSR. Look at that. That looks great. And that is depicting the lover, probably from tarot cards, if I had to guess. Yeah, that's a great looking SSR. So we'll put that out here as kind of our top card so far. I think we're about to beat it. Here's another one. I'm trying to hide this one. This is the stomach bug, so that's cute. That's a cute piece of artwork. And like I said, they do credit the artist on these. So you can see down here, it'll say Gosh and Seiko. So that's the artist who made this image, which is, I think, just fantastic that they're doing that. Okay, and so now we have the hurricane, and it is a LR. Now look at that. That is cool. Wow. Hurricane. LR. Very nice looking card. Let me get that sleeved, and I'll sleeve the SSR as well. But that is definitely our winner so far, right? Like, it's better than this SSR. We can put the SSR in second. I'm not going to put base cards on the board because they move too quickly, but those look great. If that was all we pulled today, I would be so happy with this, but we have so much more to look at here. It's kind of insane. Alright, so next up is Beast Mother, and these can be not safe for work, so I'm going to have to look at them off screen, sorry. But assuming they're safe to show you, I will show you them all. There's three cards in there. I'll just take a quick look here, and then bring them back out. Yeah, I think we're okay. So these aren't too bad, at least. So up here we have, this is the back of the card design. And this is a puzzle piece. So I have another puzzle piece from the set, but I'm not sure which one it is. I don't think it connects to this one, though. It's not this one for sure. But yeah, the puzzle pieces are difficult pulls because you would need 9 of them to make the full puzzle. And unfortunately, they made that the UR rarity. So that's a tough pull. But we'll put that there for now. Make some more space. I should have more room for the battle. Okay, and then our last card is an SR. And as you see, it's like a little bit, but it's not too bad. They have all their clothes on, at least. And we think that these images are AI generated, but no one's quite sure. Yeah, they look great. I think, there's one more, sorry, the rare. So yeah, the rare is just a regular cat lady. So there's going to be mostly cat ladies in this set, although there are some fox ladies and other things too. I've never pulled a squirrel girl yet, that might be fun. But yeah, that has not happened yet. I like the design of the rares with the lines on the border on them, so I'm going to go ahead and make that third place. And then we'll move over to the West. So this is a Topps card. So this is printed in, it's printed in, I think, Italy or something, but it's at least sold in America. And I bought, as you saw, a full hobby box of it. And it's a interesting product. I mean, the fact that the chrome is so curved is kind of actually like a serious problem, I think. It makes it really hard to, as you can see, even open the backs up. But otherwise, the cards look okay once you get them open. And it's one of those typical Topps things where there's so many different numbered parallels, so many different types of cards that you can get. I've never pulled anything really great out of here, but there's artist autograph cards, all kinds of crazy stuff. So we'll take a look at all of it. But here's Bigfoot. And so like I said, it's that cryptid, that monster type thing. And you can see the curve on that card is insane. I don't know how to correct that. I can put them all in top loaders, but it's not really going to correct it. So there's a Flatwoods monster. And there's probably like a whole wiki on this one monster if you go look. Okay, and so here we have a Funeral Mountain Terra Shot. Never heard of that one. But interesting, I guess. That is a refractor, so you can see down there it says refractor. That's why it has rainbow on it. And this one is Chibi Mothman. Interesting. Okay, so Chibi Mothman. Again, just so bent. I guess this refractor is probably the top card from those four. So let me go ahead and get that sleeved. And would it replace anything? Unfortunately, I don't think it would. It's not that I don't like the art style of these. I can put it up there. It's just that I like the art style of those better, and they have better treatments. Like, you really need to pull a gold parallel or something from this for it to make it on the board. We did that last time. We pulled a numbered to 50 space penguins from it, which is the gold refractor, and that was pretty cool. That I think actually won a battle just because of how rare it is. But when you just get the base cards, they're not going to make it on the board. Just like those base cards don't make it on the board. All right, so we're down to our last pack of round one, which will be, again, this is Monster Girl Encyclopedia, and definitely like printed to be sold in Japan. So this is marked up with all the Japanese warnings for 18 plus cards, whereas other sets like this one will have the Chinese warnings for 18 plus cards, which are less warning. But this one, in Japan, there's many more rules, and the rules are enforced. And so if you sell a product in Japan, you have to work a little harder to meet all the rules, and that's why this set is honestly very expensive most of the time. You'll find it sold for almost $100 occasionally, whereas I got my box for around 30, but I had to wait a long time for a sale. And I have to look at these off screen again. I'm really sorry about that, but I'll bring them back as soon as I'm sure they're okay. Yeah. Fortunately, they are all, I believe, very safe to show. And you'll see what I mean. They're not actually that racy at all. Like, it's just kind of a lady with skeleton armor on. I mean, you could pull that from any card set, right? It's a great artwork. And this is a common, so this is the C level, the most basic card in the set. Cards have a great feel to them and much higher quality than these. These are very cheap feeling cards compared to these. These are a little bit higher quality than even that. So here we have another common. It looks like maybe a some kind of goat lady, maybe goat, like a goat, half lady. Interesting. And then another common here. This one is maybe some sort of squid or octopus type thing. Maybe a squid with that. Yeah, that's probably a squid. I think I pulled this one earlier. I think I have a dupe of this now. And then we move into the rare level. So those were all commons. This is a rare, and it's a centipede, as you can see. Very nice foil treatment on that. I like that quite a bit. And I'm not really showing the backs because this, I mean, I can read some of that, but I can't read that all. That's more Japanese than I know, but I could read some of it. I figure there's no picture or anything on there, so there's not much point showing that. But then we have a UR. And let's try to figure out what this is. So it's a UR and it says Kimatora. Bull? Something like a bull. Bull beetle, maybe? I'm sorry, I'm having trouble. Let me translate this off screen so I stop embarrassing myself. I'll be right back. Okay, yeah, my Japanese is rusty apparently. That says chimera. It literally says kamaira in katakana. So this is a chimera. And that's why there's a griffin and things like that and a dragon head. That is a UR and beautiful looking card. Very happy to pull that. In fact, I will go ahead and make that. Well, should that be first place? Now I'm not sure. I've got to really think about this. I think I will do that. I'm going to make that first. I'm going to make this second. And I'll go ahead and take this off the board. And so that's our board right now. That one is also very nice. So I like all those cards, but Yeah, we've got to make a choice here. So let's move on. And now we're going to round two. And what we're going to do is just open them all again and see if we can get better hits up on the board. So here goes the first pack. Again, there's going to be seven cards in here, so it might take a while to get through them, but we should be able to go pretty fast, and we're probably going to start getting dupes. Unfortunately, you get a lot of dupes in this product. Let me see if I can... Okay, there's something in here kind of cool, but maybe we can hide that and put these up here instead. Here we go. Okay, so that is a forest goblin. I know I have that one already. Forest goblin. This is... Oh, I don't have that one yet, but it's some kind of cyclops. Mounter, it's called? Okay. Interesting. This is... Well, that looks really neat. That is an Oni, Japanese demon by Seraph A. Very cool. And this is a Quetzalcoatl kind of animal. Called a feather serpent, I guess. Very cool. And it's, okay, so they stole that from Dungeons and Dragons. Good job, guys. Camon, they are thieves, so they will steal art. That's what they do. This is a forest. What does that say? Glorycorn? I mean, it's a leprechaun, right? But that must be a different way of saying leprechaun, maybe in a different language. And this is a Yumekui. I've never heard of that. Oh, wait, this is the thing that takes your dreams, I think. That's what that monster does. This is an interesting story, that one. You read up on it. And then here are two SSRs. It is a triplet. That's because there's three women connected. And then this is a tearing whale. That is an interesting picture. It just kind of looks like a dead whale to me. These are SSRs, just like that. So the LR is still the best we pulled. But it's cool to get two more SSRs. And I don't have either of these SSRs, so yeah, I'm happy to get them. Here we go. Very nice. And then let's go ahead and move on. Oh, maybe put one of those up there. And let's open up the next Beast Mother. And we'll get three cards out of this. And it's another set where I'll have to look at it off screen. Sorry about that. But I will bring them back as soon as I can. So there's three cards in there. A little bit of a different back on this. Maybe something I haven't seen before. Let's see. Well, nothing too crazy here, but here we have a little, maybe a fox lady of some kind. And that's that rare treatment, just like the other. This rare is prettier than that one, but we'll see all the cards and then make a choice. Does it actually say? Gosh, I'm trying to read what that says and I can't. I don't know what that says. Okay, we got another SR here. SR. And last time we got a puzzle piece in the hit slot. This time we got an actual card there, but it's not a very high rarity card, sorry. So we didn't get super lucky. It is just an SSR. So there we have... I mean, it's got a pretty foil treatment to it, but it's kind of constant across the whole card. Still, I think this SSR can take the place of that R. It definitely looks better. So I think I'll go with this one. It's a nice looking card. That's with the purple. I've never had a purple back before. Cool. So there's third place is a Beast Mother SSR. Wow, what an... I'm just marveling at what's on the table here. It's so weird. I love weird, and so being... Yeah, part of the archetype is being weird, so this is certainly weird. Okay, we got another very curved pack of chrome cards here. It's going to be tough to get them out. You'll notice it says this little H means it's a hobby pack. That's just to differentiate it from blaster packs, which will have worse odds. So the hobby packs will have better odds. We've, like I said, that 50 penguins was the best thing I've ever pulled from any of these. I don't know that the better odds helped me much. But here's a slide rock bolter, a tripodero, that's cute, and then a bat squat, that's kind of neat. That's probably just a refractor. Yeah, just a refractor. And then this is Salem Witches. Cool. So I can... Why don't I pause here and sleeve these so you don't have to watch me sleeve, and then I'll come back. Right, I've got those all sleeved up. Nothing too fancy here again. So unfortunately, Metazoo is not going to be taking any spots on the podium, it seems like. But we'll see who survives our last pack here of Monster Girl Encyclopedia. It's interesting that these all have hangers on them. I wonder if the intention is to sell them individually, the packs. It seems like they're labeled and like they have all the warnings and things that you would need to sell them individually. I don't know if that's their intention. Okay, so I have to look at these off screen. I'll be right back. Yeah, I don't know why I even bothered. None of these have been not safe for work even at all yet. So here we have a kind of seaweed undersea lady. And there is a kind of Cupid type... Cupid, I guess. Fury? That's a fury? Okay. Maybe I'm probably saying that. Sorry, my Japanese is very rusty. I think that's Curry, but I don't know. Okay, so we have another one. It's like a Chinese ghost. This kind of hat, it always means a ghost from China. And there's a whole like, yeah, ghost has a very specific meaning to the Chinese. It's not quite the same as our way of saying it. So there's a mermaid, rare, very pretty. Love the foil treatment. I love that the foil doesn't take away from the foreground artwork. And then we have an SR, and that is a griffin, some kind of griffin. And I love the SSRs have, you know, beautiful etching, but also this great overprinting of the musical notes. That's great. Each one has a different pattern, but this one's kind of musical notes. That's a nice looking card. I'm not sure it beats anything on the board, though. I kind of like the board the way it is still. So, okay, we've seen now a bunch of cards, many, many more cards, and we're going to keep this lineup. So this is our lineup that we're going to end the battle with. I wish that one, that is, there we go. So Beast Mother in third place with an SSR. Abnormity Hunter League in second place with an amazing LR, like quite a good pull there. But Monster Girl Encyclopedia wins with this UR Chimera. Very nice piece of artwork here with some great, I love like this blue foil over here is very nice. And yeah, anyway, I like that card. So that is definitely our winner. So there we go. First, second, third. And that is Cryptid Conundrum. Hope you enjoyed the battle. Let me know in the comments if you didn't or you did or whatever. Any advice you can give me, I will take. I need all the advice I can get. And we're at 30 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. And yeah, I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.